One of the big challenges in voxel-based games is how to build smooth, curvy structures. Some guidelines exist on how to build spheres of varying size, but more complex designs require careful planning. In this tutorial, we'll look at how to use ICE to generate a layer-by-layer plan of a voxel structure, starting from a closed mesh. To follow along, you'll need to download the voxelizer compound, which we've provided as a zip file in the description section of this video. You'll also need a closed mesh representation of the structure you want to build. We'll be using the default T-Rex mesh as an example. Create a new point cloud in the scene. Set the point cloud's parent to the same null as the mesh. Open the Ice Tree editor. Select Create Ice Tree. Under the Compounds menu, select Import Compound. Import the voxelizer compound. Connect it to the ice tree. Add a Get Data node. Double-click on it and select Explorer. Select the polygon mesh. Connect the value port to the geometry input. And connect the out name to the in name input. In the viewport, some voxels should appear inside the mesh. Here, the voxelizer compound's default values have been set to work with the T-Rex. To see how to configure the compound to work with your own mesh, reset all its inputs to zero. Make sure you've also disabled the Enable checkbox. Set the viewport to shaded mode and enable the headlight so we can work with solid boxes instead of wireframes. To start off, set the box size to 1. Set the grid color to a light gray. Increase the number in X, Y, and Z as follows. A grid of boxes should appear under your mesh. Decrease the box size to reduce any overlaps along the X axis. Change the number in Z to close the gaps along the Z axis. Your boxes should now be evenly spaced. Set the box color to an opaque white. Set the top layer color to a transparent turquoise. Increase the visible layer number. Increase the number in Y to reduce the gaps along the Y axis. You may also need to adjust the visible layer number to accommodate for your change in the number of boxes on the Y axis. Your model should now be completely surrounded by evenly spaced boxes. Check Enable to display the boxes within your model. Toggle your model's view and render visibility. Back in the ice tree, add a current frame node. Connect its output to the visible layer number port. The current frame will now drive the top layer's visibility. To render top-down snapshots of each layer, add an orthographic camera into the scene. Set the viewport's camera to ortho. Set the camera's mode to shaded and turn on the headlight. Use the view cube to place the camera on top of the model and rotate it such that the model occupies the length of the frame. To reduce our voxel resolution, we'll increase the box size and reduce the number of boxes along the X, Y, and Z axes. When we scrub the timeline forward, the blue squares represent the boxes to place at the current level. We'll be using the hardware renderer to render our voxel plan, so we'll need to hide all the nulls in the view. Open the Render Manager. Set the Pass Renderer to Hardware Renderer. Set the format to JPEG. And set the pass frames to frame range. Set the pass camera to ortho. Select the hardware renderer on the left and set the background color to white. we can now render each frame of our voxel plan. Use the sequence of JPEG images in your Render Pictures folder as your guide to know which boxes to add at each level of your structure. If you're interested in how the voxelizer compound was built, expand it and consult its commented sections. We'll conclude this video with a time-lapse of the T-Rex's construction accompanied by smooth jazz.